dear students, how are you all? I hope you all are safe at home. This is the third video lecture of EVS class 4, chapter 4. In the last video, I have given one question to you. The question was, what do we call cutting of trees? Let's discuss what we call this. Dear students, cutting of trees is called deforestation. Now, we will study deforestation in detail. Deforestation is the permanent removal of trees to make room free for something besides forest. Or we can say deforestation is the removal of a forest so that the land on which it stood may be put to another use. We can divide the reasons of deforestation under two categories. First is natural causes, such as fires and floods. As we all heard recently about Amazon fires, in this way deforestation occurs naturally. Second is human activities. According to research, subsistence farming is responsible for 48% of deforestation. Commercial agriculture is responsible for 32%. Logging is responsible for 14%. And fuel wood removals make up 5%. Let's discuss these terms one by one. Subsistence farming. This is farming by local people, traditionally by family groups. In this, small parts of the forest are cut and burned down to make room for a family's crops and livestock. Commercial farming. It is carried out by business and governments. Commercial farming is a type of farming in which crops are grown for commercial use only, that is, for selling purpose only. Logging. Logging is the process of cutting trees, processing them, and moving them to a location for transport. Wood fuel or fuel wood. Today, burning of wood is the largest use of energy derived from a solid fuel biomass. Wood fuel may be used for cooking and heating. Deforestation affects adversely. Let's discuss one by one the effects of deforestation. As we know, forest is natural home of many species of birds, animals, insects, etc. When large areas of the rainforest are cleared, many species lose their natural home. In the rainforest, the roots of all the trees bind the soil. When the trees are chopped down, the rain washes away the soil, causing flooding. Deforestation can change the local climate. When trees are cleared, the temperature in the daytime can increase and nighttime temperature decrease. With fewer trees creating water vapor, there is less cloud and less rainfall. Forests reflect more heat into the atmosphere, creating a cooling effect. However, the loss of trees causes warming effect. Millions of people in the world depend on foresters for hunting, small-scale agriculture, gathering, and medicine. Deforestation disturbs the lives of millions of people. Students, I hope you understand deforestation and its causes and effects. I am very sure that the question arises in your mind, how can we stop or control it? We can do so by conservation of forest. Forest conservation is the practice of planning and maintaining forested areas for the benefit and sustainability of future generations. Steps to conserve trees are: cutting should be regulated by adopting methods like clear cutting, selective cutting. Clear cutting method is useful for those areas where the same type of trees are available over a large area. In that case, trees of same age group can be cut down in a selected area and then marked for replantation. In selective cutting, only mature trees are selected for cutting. This process is to be followed in rotation. Control over forest fire. Loss of forest by fire is fairly common because trees are highly exposed to fire, and once started, it becomes difficult to control. Sometimes the fire starts by natural processes, that is by lightning or wind events. But in most cases, they were begun by man. In order to save forests from the fire, it is necessary to adopt latest techniques of firefighting like arrangement of water spray, fire retardant chemicals. There must be trained staff of firefighters to control the fire. Reforestation. Reforestation refers to the replanting of trees on land that has previously had trees, but where these trees were cut down recently. This concept dictates that any forested land which has been destroyed by fire or mining activities should be reforested. Afforestation. Afforestation is the establishment of a forest in an area where there was no previous tree cover. According to this concept, fresh afforestation programs should be started. For this, selection of trees should be done according to local weather conditions. Protection of forests. The existing forests should be protected. There are several forest diseases which cause destruction of trees. The forests should be protected either by use of chemical spray or antibiotics. Forests can be used as tourist centers. By using them as tourist centers, the country can earn money. This is a good method of forest conservation. So, in this way, we can conserve forests. Kids, this is all about today's lecture. We will meet soon through the next video lecture. Till that time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you for watching.